Hello, everyone. Welcome to a big episode of NWA Smoky Mountain TV. John Morehouse joined by Tony the Dragon Givens, and tonight is the night. Battle of the Belts 2015 from the Civic Auditorium in Kingsport. Five big championship matches on tap, including a big double main event. Vince Brent challenges Steve Anthony for the NWA World Junior Heavyweight title, plus Jason Kincaid defends the NWA Southeastern title, puts that near four-year reign on the line against Ring of Honor star Cedric Alexander. We'll see Jason the Gift Kincaid in action later this week. Also, TV champion Jordan Cage, he's in the ring right now. Let's go right to the action. Here we go, Jordan Cage, Andrew Boyd, singles action here. John Morehouse, Tony Givens calling all the action. Thank you for joining us for another jam-packed hour of wrestling action. Jordan Cage going to be in action tonight against Ali Shabazz, a man he knows pretty well by now, Tony Givens. But this time there is a twist. If Jordan Cage is disqualified, he will lose that NWA Smoky Mountain TV title. The picture-perfect reign, the self-proclaimed picture-perfect reign, will come to an end tonight if Jordan Cage is DQ'd.
Jordan Cage's back is definitely against the wall. No time limit. And if Jordan Cage gets disqualified, like he did just a few weeks ago, Ali Shabazz will finally get the monkey off of his back and defeat Jordan Cage and become the NWA Smoky Mountain TV champion.
You talk about champion's advantage and that sort of thing. The champion's advantage pretty much thrown out the window for this match on Jordan Cage. We'll see if Ali Shabazz can finally break through and defeat Jordan Cage for that title after several close calls, several hard-fought matches between those two men. And right now, Jordan Cage really having his way with a good young competitor, Andrew Boyd, but not sure if Andrew Boyd is yet on the level of the TV champion, picture-perfect Jordan Cage, as he gets a two count there on that lateral press.
Andrew Boyd is going to be a force to be reckoned with one day, but he's just starting out. He doesn't have the experience right now to go toe-to-toe with Jordan Cage, but I could be surprised here. I could be wrong.
You know, you didn't see Jordan Cage hook the leg there on that last pin attempt. He may be looking past Andrew Boyd. He may be thinking about tonight, thinking about facing Ali Shabazz in a match with some high stakes where he, you know, he cannot get disqualified. There is no time limit.
It only takes 3 seconds to beat a man. You don't need to overlook anybody. Jordan Cage would be focusing on Andrew Boyd right now and worry about Ali Shabazz tonight.
Laying in some clotheslines now on Andrew Boyd, really just dragging him all over the ring. STO there by Jordan Cage.
That was actually a flatliner or a downward spiral. STO.
My mistake.
Is the other way. It's okay.
I was looking at it backwards, so it looked like it. Never mind. I just screwed that up. It happens. Jordan Cage with a two count there. Big night of action tonight. Battle of the Belts. NWA Southeastern title, NWA World Junior Heavyweight title, NWA U.S. Tag titles are all at stake. Jordan Cage hoists Andrew Boyd with a big belly-to-back suplex. Jordan Cage, one of the most well-rounded, technically gifted wrestlers on the entire roster, Tony Givens.
A great professional wrestler is Jordan Cage. Burst on the scene just a couple of years ago. I'll tell you what, I saw him on YouTube in a match with Jason Kincaid that went 1 hour, a one-hour time limit draw. The next day, I called this man, got his contact information, and I booked him as soon as I could possibly get him. This guy right here, I mean, he impressed me from day one. I brought him in, and he is a great, great competitor.
I've said it several times on this program. Don't really think Jordan Cage needs the agency, needs Dillon Sizemore's philosophy and those tactics to be a success here. He's chosen that route, and in many ways think that makes him even more dangerous because he's willing to do literally whatever it takes to reach where he wants to be in the sport. It comes up empty there on the corner attack. Andrew Boyd's got Jordan Cage up. Jordan Cage in a bad spot here. What's Andrew Boyd going to do?
Just dropped him right across his knee.
There you
and
go.
Now a big, oh,
nice
wow.
DDT. Wait, great combination by Andrew Boyd.
He may put this man away. It may be Andrew Boyd tonight.
What an upset here. Andrew Boyd, no. Jordan Cage able to kick out.
That TV title is on the line every time Jordan Cage comes out here and wrestles on television. We might not want to overlook Andrew Boyd because he very well may. He may be the TV champion.
Jordan Cage up again. Jordan will counter it.
Now that is an STO.
That was an STO.
And not only that, he actually clawed his head like a claw hole and got the extra impact of driving his skull into the mat. That's the concussion city right there. And what is he going for right here?
Laying in forearms on that back.
The aggressive streak here of Jordan Cage. And look.
Backcracker there.
And got the extra momentum by putting him up on the ropes.
See the eyes of Andrew Boyd bulging out of his head after that impact. Just jars the spine, the ribs, the
he
kidneys.
He can't do this. This is illegal.
Wait a minute.
This
going for that hangman's pile driver.
He'll get disqualified.
He's waving it off.
He's not doing it. What's he doing here? Oh, just drives the knee right into the face.
Broken picture one there by Jordan Cage into a brain buster.
This has got to be it right here.
That might do it. And that does do it. I'm going to go try to get a word with the TV champion heading into tonight's big match. Not only will there be no time limit, if you are disqualified, you will lose that title to Ali Shabazz at this event tonight in Kingsport. Want to get your thoughts.
Who made that deal? Who made that deal? Who signed that? Huh?
That's crap, Morehouse.
The ruling was made after the controversy we saw a few weeks ago between yourself and Ali.
Wait. You know what? That's fine. Jordan, you're the better man. You can play within the rules and beat him again. Why? Why can you do that? Because you are picture perfect.
Well, we'll see if that self-proclaimed picture perfect TV title reign is going to end tonight or not. Battle of the Belts 2015, Civic Auditorium in Kingsport, Jordan Cage and Ali Shabazz, one of five huge championship matches. More action on Smoky Mountain TV when we return.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great non-for-profit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
Hello, I'm Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries. Carpets are soft, it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So.
Man, what happened?
funny. I was just driving along and a horse just came out of the sky. So,
get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Welcome back to the program, NWA Smoky Mountain TV. A huge announcement about Battle of the Belts tonight in Kingsport, Tennessee. Tony Givens, after what we saw last week, the controversial ending to the match between the U.S. champions Chase Owens and Chris Richards against Axton Ray and Skylar Cruz. NWA President R. Bruce Tharp has weighed in, said the U.S. tag titles will be on the line tonight, the Illuminati defending against Axton Ray and Skylar Cruz. Oh, Skylar with a nice counter on the boot. Oh, but he did no counter for that, Tony. Big forearm. Now we're seeing the double teamwork by the champions. This drop kick by Chase Owens.
Pinpoint drop kick right to the face. That could be a knockout blow. This could be it.
Oh, I thought that might have been it, Tony. Axton Ray was in no shape, no condition to go in and make the save for his partner. But Skylar Cruz had the wherewithal to be able to get a shoulder up at about 2.5. Fire Skylar off. Another double team coming. Skylar fighting out of it, though. Oh.
He kicked him in the belly. Throws him out.
There goes Chase.
Oh, yeah. What's this? Chris Richards hits him from behind. He goes to shoot him off. What's going to go on here?
Nice low bridge there by Skylar Cruz.
Oh, he was going for that super kick.
Blocked it, though. Oh!
Holy man. I'm not sure if that was an elbow or just a fist to the face.
Missile drop kick by Axton Ray.
And he's back up. Axton Ray showing his resilience. He is coming out of nowhere. He's coming.
Look out! Oh!
Oh man!
Chase Owens evades the dive.
Oh, and he's grabbing his knee. This could be bad news.
Axton Ray lands hard. Skylar Cruz off the rope.
Grabbing his knee here, man.
Choke slam
this
coming
right here.
Wait, no. Oh, super kick.
I don't think he got all of it though.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh no!
Chase just leveled him. Now Chase Owens with the super kick. He just clocked his partner. Skylar Cruz with the pin. He's got him. One, two, three. Skylar Cruz and Axton. He's got Chris Richards pin. He's got him.
If the referee was not on the floor here. What's Chase Owens doing here? Chase Owens just put on an elbow pad.
Like a very familiar elbow pad as well. Shades of the past. Oh!
Roaring elbow out of nowhere from the floor. He is cold cocked. Skylar Cruz out of nowhere. And right here.
Skylar Cruz is motionless. Chris Richards with the cover. And there it is.
I'm not so sure about that, John Morehouse.
You know, I'm a little aggravated with the match that we have tonight. Axton Ray, Skylar Cruz, we said if you beat us, you would get a tag team title shot. But you didn't beat us. Why are we in this match?
You know, apparently last week you boys didn't get enough. But tonight, you're going to get everything we got. Because last week on television, we were in good moods. But tonight at the Kingsport Civic Auditorium, we're in bad moods, and we're going to show everybody he who holds the power rules the world.
I was thinking about this. But you on the news, yeah, they see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause all of my life, training day in and night, I'm preparing to fight for everyone, never.
insane. Hear they screaming our name while we spraying champagne. Nothing nobody can say, cause today is that day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever. When you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Oh, world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time. After push up, everybody count it out. Everybody up, now we back down. All our pain and sweat was for this moment right now. All from different places, but we came with each other. We came together as a team, but we leaving as brothers. Standing next to one another while we hold up our colors.
I'm gonna look into the camera and tell my mama I love her. Cause
today is that day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. My hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world, all my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time.
Today is the day that I have always dreamed of. And forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world.
I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time. Today is that day. It's the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever. When you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. Whole world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
Hello, I'm Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries, Carpet Society. Soft, it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So.
Man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and the horse just came out of the sky. So.
Get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
We'll be right back.
More action here on the program. NWA Smoky Mountain TV as the countdown to Battle of Belts continues tonight at the Civic Auditorium in Kingsport. Tony Gibbons, both these men are going to be in action. Jeff Connolly goes against Wild Bill, determined to unmask Wild Bill and improve his theory that it's Daniel Mulligan. Meanwhile, Prince Valiant Nick Stanley, he's going to be there against Mr. Everybody Knows Sean Schultz. Two very intriguing singles matchups taking place tonight in Kingsport.
It is the battle for the belts. The NWA Saw television title will be on the line. Our friends at NWA Showtime All-Star Wrestling out of Nashville, Sean Schultz is their television champion, and he will be defending his title against Nick Stanley tonight in Kingsport.
We saw Sean Schultz really have a battle with Ring of Honor star Cedric Alexander last month at Fire on the Mountain. Cedric Alexander is going to be there as well, challenging Jason Kincaid for that NWA Southeastern heavyweight title. But really, even in the losing effort, Sean Schultz acquitted himself quite well. We'll see what he can do now that his coveted TV title is on the line against Nick Stanley tonight in Kingsport. This is actually a rematch from a few months ago on the television program, Tony. It was Prince Valiant's debut, took on Jeff Connolly. The closer used that knee brace of his to finish off Stanley. We'll see what happens here on the rematch. Prince Valiant coming off a nice win of his own a few weeks ago against Benny Connolly, the cousin of the ring general of chaos, Jeff Connolly.
He might be just taking out the whole family here.
Cousin twice removed, if my research is correct.
Look at this here. Taking Jeff Connolly down with a clothesline. You know, Nick Stanley is really put together. He's a good athlete. Great to have him here in NWA Smoky Mountain. He has earned his right to be a member of the NWA Smoky Mountain roster, and he will be taking on SAW TV champion Sean Schultz tonight in Kingsport. And what should be a great match. Also, like we talked about, Jeff Connolly, once again, trying to unmask Wild Bill. They will go one-on-one. Who knows what's going to happen there?
A lot of action on the line. We just learned about the U.S. tag title match that's going to be happening. Chase Owens and Chris Richards put those titles at stake against Axton Rae and Skylar Cruz. Skylar Cruz appeared to have Chris Richards beat last week on this program. Then Chase Owens pulled out the loaded elbow pad, something we've not seen in a while. Get the win there. Now
a stun gun, like we talked about before. Those ropes, they're not string. They're not just ropes here. The ropes we have here are elevator cables surrounded by just a thin, very thin layer of rubber. That hurts when you put a man's throat across it. I mean, you could do some serious damage. You could damage a trachea.
Some of the signature offense of Jeff Connolly there. That spinning suplex off the corner. It's kind of refreshing to just see one person in the corner of Jeff Connolly for this match. Judas the Mad Hatter. Usually the whole Chaos Horde is out there rooting him on. Chaos has the chance to leave tonight with some newfound gold as the giant Travis Lee, the enforcer of Chaos, goes against Nick Hammers for that Mountain Empire title.
I truly believe that Chaos is in the background here. The reason they're not out here is they're all preparing for tonight. I mean, we have big matches. Jeff Connolly only has a big match. But like I said, Travis Lee, he has a big match against the Mountain Empire champion, Nick Hammonds. And look, oh, wow, reversal there, throwing the elbow right up against the ropes. What's Jeff Connolly doing now? Snapmare, what's he going for here?
Kick right to the back.
Just a kick. See, that's the vicious streak right there. He could have slapped on a submission hold and went for the victory, but he kicks the man right in the back. Then he goes for the cover here.
Definitely seen a more sadistic side of Jeff Connolly emerge in the past year and a half since he aligned himself with Chaos. He was part of that night when everything formed in this stable. You were there too. I was as well. It was a very shocking evening.
And you know what? That original Chaos looks nothing like the Chaos today, because Jeff Connolly really molded Chaos. The last man standing molded Chaos into his own vision, along with Judas the Mad Hatter. You know, they are the leaders of this thing. And they have been a force to be reckoned with here in NWA Smoky Mountain.
Connolly measuring Nick Stanley with that knee. He's beating him with that same move before. Nick Stanley saw it coming this time. Nice scouting by Prince Valiant, and he drops Jeff Connolly with the clothesline. There's another clothesline. Nick Stanley firing up here, Tony.
Well, he's really taking it to him here. And what could this be?
Oh,
wow. I think he hit him with the toe of the boot. That's not good. What's this? Well, it could be this here.
Wait a minute.
Oh, that's it.
Oh, there he goes.
That's a disqualification.
Jeff Connolly dumps Prince Valiant. Stanley over the top rope.
Over the top
Stanley
rope.
Stanley hit hard, and he's hurt.
Over the top rope disqualification here. In effect, NWA rules. You can't throw a man over the top rope. It is dangerous, especially you take a man over the top rope. That is a long way to the floor, especially, you know.
And like, Judas getting a kick in there.
Like we talked about here, Nick Stanley may be hurt. Like we talked about here in the past, we're here at Evolution Sports Gym in Elizabeth, Tennessee. That is AstroTurf. They have a indoor football field here. We are set up there. That is AstroTurf. That is nothing but hard concrete under that. And Nick Stanley may need some help.
Nick Stanley, the winner of this match, hopefully not too injured. Got a big match against Sean Schultz tonight. So does that man, Jeff Connolly. Will he succeed? Will he succeed? Wild Bill, you're next. Can he unmask the masked man from Texas? We'll find out tonight. More action when we return.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great non-for-profit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
Hello, I'm Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries, Carpets of Soft, it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're a family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So.
Man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just like came out of the sky. So.
Get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Jeff Connolly is trying to wear this man down, and he's doing a good job of it right now.
It's been kind of a hit or miss year for Jeff Connolly. You know, he, as we said, four-time TV champion, was the runner-up in the Smoky Mountain Cup himself against Jax Dane, came down to the finals, and then we saw Jax Dane basically battled the entire faction of Chaos before winning that tournament and that shot at the NWA World's Heavyweight Championship.
I just want to say, since you've mentioned it, get well soon, Jax Dane. super impressive. We want you to come back as soon as possible. The fans of NWA Smoky Mountain miss you, and get well soon.
Covered by Jeff Connolly there. Only a two count.
Sorry to go away from the match there. Just wanted to shout out Jack Stane. But you know what? Jeff Connolly almost beat Jack Stane in that Smoky Mountain Cup. You know, I know the runner-up doesn't get a title shot. Runner-up doesn't get anything. But Jeff Connolly showed that night that he is – not only is he talented, he's smart enough to put together a plan. Jeff Connolly, Judas the Mad Hatter, may be the leader of Chaos, but inside that ring, Jeff Connolly is – the ring general.
Absolutely, he's the ring general, and he's got all kinds of troops at his disposal, whether it's Travis Lee, Cody Blade, Travis Dykes, Sarah Dox. He's got the whole list of them lined up, reinforcements there at his disposal.
Really, they're just clubbering the man, just beating him down, you know. A different strategy from Connolly. Not only he has applied a few submission holds, but mainly he's just trying to beat this big man down. Look, he lost his grip there. It's very hot in here. We got the lights.
Hard to throw a big man like Wild
it's
Bill
hard
around.
To throw a big man like that, especially when you got the sweat going on and you've got a loose grip. People are chanting for Wild Bill, willing him to make a comeback. Jeff Connolly, no way he can hit this. This is it's like going for his tornado snap suplex.
Wild Bill fights him off. Jeff Connolly's a strong man. I don't think he's that strong. And Wild Bill, you talk about clubbering. There's a big clubbering forearm there by Wild Bill.
Wild Bill showing there's still fight left in him. He ain't going down easily. It doesn't matter how many men are out there. And he's making, looks like he's making himself a comeback here. And what's this?
Avalanche.
Big splash. And hey, here you go. What's this?
Snap suplex.
Now, that's a snap suplex. Take him down. You see, you know what? Sometimes you hold a man up and hold him up for the vertical suplex, hold him up high in the air, and yeah, it's pretty, but it doesn't do the damage that a snap suplex does. Take the man quick, all impact, and that is what Wild Bill did. Now he is climbing to the top rope. Could it be the diving headbutt?
Wait a minute. There's Travis Lee. He's got Wild Bill. Throws him off the top. It's going to be disqualifications. Senior official Smoke Carver is calling a stop to that, and now Travis Lee is in the ring, and we see that numbers game.
Like I said, these men do not care about winning this match. The only thing the only thing they want to do is to take off his mask. Oh, here comes Nick Hammonds.
Jeff Connolly with that loaded knee. Nick Hammonds in the ring. He's got that steel chair. We saw it last week. He made the save. Nick Hammonds just blasts Travis Lee with the – oh, my God.
Wow. Hit no impact.
Didn't faze him.
Oh, wow.
Two blows with that chair. Travis Lee wasn't even fazed, Tony Givens. Look at that.
Kingsport, Tennessee, tonight's the night, and you are in for a big treat. Mr. Wild Bill, Mr. Daniel Mulligan, that punk that couldn't stay away. Jeff Connolly is going to unmask that idiot tonight and be done with him once and for all. Wrestling business is over, Daniel Mulligan. Get over it. And second of all, my giant Travis Lee is going to take Nick Hammonds and finally put him out of business as the Mountain Empire champion. So there will be two poor souls taken care of all in one night here in the Civic Auditorium.
More action on the program here as we count down to Battle of the Belts tonight in Kingsport. Earlier, Tony Givens, we heard from Jason Kincaid about tonight's big match against Ring of Honor star Cedric Alexander for Kincaid's coveted NWA Southeastern Heavyweight title. Right now in non-title action against Billy Litt. Billy Litt, kind of new to NWA Smoky Mountain. He is not shying away from tough competition. Faced Chris Richards a few weeks ago and now going against the longest current reigning champion in the entire National Wrestling Alliance.
Billy Litt, no stranger to Jason Kincaid either. These men have wrestled many, many times, both men from West Virginia. I don't think there's any hatred in this matchup. I think these guys, that Billy Litt just trying to prove himself against the best. And I expect to see a clean contest, a good contest here. Billy Litt showing what his worth is against the champion.
Mutual respect definitely between these two competitors. I expect more of the same tonight. Mutual respect between Jason Kincaid and Cedric Alexander. You heard what the gift had to say, called Cedric Alexander one of the best wrestlers in the world. We'll see who emerges victorious tonight. Both men had big wins in singles action at Fire on the Mountain last month, but the stakes are raised for Cedric Alexander tonight as he tries to end Jason Kincaid's title reign just before he reaches that four-year anniversary. 4 years at reign as a champion, almost unprecedented in the sport of professional wrestling, Tony Givens, especially these days.
Exactly. The longest reigning champion in all of professional wrestling is Jason Kincaid. He's defeated a who's who, a laundry list, and tonight, can he defeat Cedric Alexander? Oh, look at that, landing on his feet out of the monkey flip, and he's happy about it. You see his look on his face?
A golf clap there by Jason Kincaid.
Yeah. Yeah, he's happy he landed on his feet. Very impressive.
A lot of sportsmanship between these two. I don't expect a lot of sportsmanship in some of the other matches we're going to see tonight in Kingsport. Definitely bad blood between
He didn't land on his feet that time.
No, he did not. Definitely bad blood between the Heat Seekers and Toby Farrell and Gavin Derry in that match.
You see Jason Kincaid taking advantage of that. You know, the
oh.
Billy Litt tried to leapfrog, didn't get all the way over. Went down. Jason Kincaid takes advantage. You know, well, the sign of a champion is one of the things that, you know, other than having the heart that Jason Kincaid has, is being able to take advantage of opportunities. And, oh, wow.
Oh. Got him hooked there. That's interesting.
Very impressive. What's this?
Springboard back elbow.
Yeah.
Going for the cover. This will be a big upset here. Kincaid kicks out at two.
Slaps a rear chin lock on here. Almost a sleeper, the way he's got him there. But Jason Kincaid still got enough. Can't slap it on him yet because Jason still has the strength. And look at picking him up, almost a fireman's carry. He's trying to get out of that sleeper hold.
Yeah, you mentioned the who's who of challengers that Kincaid has turned back, especially in recent months. John Morrison back in May at Collision Course. Sabu and Vince Brenton in Extreme Rules three-way dance at the Summer Bash. Matt Sydal just a few weeks ago at Fire on the Mountain. And 2 weeks ago on this very program, surviving a match against the hard-hitting Toby Farley in his debut double stomp by Kincaid.
That Jason Kincaid countered his charge in the corner with almost an Alabama slam. And let me tell you, that is one of the hardest hitting maneuvers in professional wrestling, because you're taking the guy's momentum all the way from high up, pulling him leg and pushing him down, and then follows up with a double stomp. Uh-oh. It looks like he's going to do the Rene Romero special here.
Trying to hoist him back here. And there he goes.
Well, there it is. This is a extremely painful maneuver.
Stressing the entire body, all the joints. Getting pulled out of whack by Jason Kincaid here.
I have seen grown men cry. Oh, look at it, and going into the cover here. Jason Kincaid, very smart, but his shoulders may be down as well.
Do you think all the tough challenges that Jason Kincaid has faced in recent months, might he be a little worn down tonight as he prepares to face Cedric Alexander, Tony?
Let me tell you something. One time Jason, when he was just at 1,000 days as champion.
Just.
How ironic that is. He told me that the championship is like a weight, and every single title defense, that weight gets heavier. So, I mean, it's weighing down on him. This man, I mean, the pressure. Every time to defend the longest reign in all of professional wrestling. And look at this big clothesline right there. You know, I'm going to tell you, like I said before, Jason Kincaid, when he charges in that corner, he steps up on the opposite turnbuckle. It gives him so much momentum. I mean, you ever seen the Sonic the Hedgehog where you push the down button and he spins real fast and then you let go and he flies? That's like what it is. Sorry for the dated reference, but that's the best thing I could come up with for an analogy.
It's fine. I'm sure a few people listening or watching saw that duel. Look at that. Fantastic counter to the head scissors by Kincaid. And a spin kick clocks Billy Litt in the side of the head.
You know what is scary? There are things that Jason Kincaid does that is incredibly difficult, like that handstand and kept back up to his feet. He does it so flawlessly that it actually looks easy. That's how fluid he is. I mean, he is so fluid in the ring. And here, this is the horse collar. Rarely used maneuver, trapping both arms, putting pressure on the neck and the back. Great submission maneuver.
Great athlete is Jason Kincaid. Great balance, great innovator in professional wrestling.
See that? Billy Litt's smart enough. He's well scouted, knew that if he leaned back, he could put Jason Cade's shoulders on the mat. Jason Cade had to grab the ropes and let go of the hole to escape the pinfall cover there. Jason Cade shoots him off. Here he goes again. The Sonic the Hedgehog. Oh, wow.
Oh, Billy Litt had it scouted, and Jason Kincaid hung out to dry here. Matt has seen that familiarity we talked about between these two men.
I don't think Jason is okay.
No.
I think he
the weekend plans are ruined now.
I think
weekend
plans are ruined, and you know what? We joke around that, but that's actually I've seen matches decided upon low blows. That was not intentional. What's this? Wow. Uranagi suplex into a slam there, into a sit-down powerbomb, almost enough for a three count.
You know, we it seems like every week here recently on Smoky Mountain TV, we've seen somebody pulling off some offensive maneuver that we've not seen before and haven't seen in a long time. Everybody's pulling out all the stops, trying to impress and stake their claim here in NWA Smoky Mountain.
Oh, could it be? There it is. Oh. Haven't seen that one in a while. He beat me with that his first night in.
Shoulder up by Billy Litt, though.
But Billy Litt is apparently tougher than me.
Billy Litt showing a lot of fight here against a man he knows well, as you alluded to.
As I said, I have taken that maneuver. Jason Cade, on his first night in the NWA Smoky Mountain, January 2009, defeated me with that maneuver. Just slapping him. Mutual respect may have went out the window because Jason, at this point, he just needs to defend his title. Wow. Wow, these guys are – he's standing up to him.
Fire away.
Wow, punch to the jaw.
Another one.
I tell you what. I don't know how many times I've seen Jason Cade resort to throwing punches. And Billy Litt looks like he's in pain. He's rocked.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Big clothesline. What's he got here?
Kincaid sizing him up. I think these fans are a little surprised to see Kincaid throwing those punches like you mentioned.
It's very rarely that Jason has to resort to throwing punches. Usually his technical ability and his legal striking ability is enough to put his opponents away, but you know what? I mean, he's had some big challenges lately. Like I said, the championship is like a weight weighing down on his chest, and every day that weight gets a little bit heavier.
Billy Litt hooking Kincaid up for a superplex here. This would do some serious damage to the Gift, heading into a very important title match tonight against Cedric Alexander. Headbutt by Kincaid.
Uh-oh. Oh, could it be a big double stomp here coming up?
Oh, Billy Litt had it scouted.
Oh,
Kincaid.
Well, Kincaid hurt his leg. But he's still going. Billy Litt couldn't take advantage in time. What's this? Billy Litt with a
neck breaker, possibly.
Oh, wow, right to the face. Knee. Could be going for that big maneuver again that he hit earlier. Oh, yeah. Stringing together some offense, combination offense.
But
by
Kincaid,
Billy Litt,
the ring awareness rolling out.
That's the mark of being a champion. Great ring awareness, knowing where he is. And Billy, Billy Litt looks like he's going to fly here. What's he going to do?
Oh!
Oh, well, he caught him. Drake
saw it
coming. He draped him across the ropes, and could it be? Here it is. Here it is. Could it be? And he's showing that. Hey, that's just straight to Cedric Alexander right there. The grave of the Fireflies, and nobody kicks out of Jason Cade's finishing maneuver.
Impressive win for Kincaid, an exciting match with Billy Litt. We'll see if Kincaid can emerge victorious tonight against Cedric Alexander at Battle of the Belts.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
Hello, I'm Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries, Carpets of Soft, it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I mean, I have some car issues. Could you really use a loan? So,
man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just like came out of the sky. So,
get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Main event on the program as we continue the countdown to Battle of the Belts. All four of these men are going to be in action tonight in Kingsport. Gavin Daring and Toby Farley from the agency going against Mountain Empire champion Nick Hammond and Ali Shabazz. Hammond puts his Mountain Empire title on the line tonight against the Enforcer of Chaos, Travis Lee. Shabazz gets another crack at the TV title holder, Jordan Cage. If Jordan Cage gets disqualified, he will lose the title. Also, no time limit in that match. And then we've got Gavin Daring and Toby Farley in a big tag team grudge match against the Heat Seekers. Current agency against former agency Tony Givens. It's going to be a huge night at the Civic Auditorium.
That's right, man. What a great stacked lineup we have tonight. Titles on the line. World Junior title on the line. Southeastern heavyweight title on the line. Saw's television title on the line. Our television title on the line. Just a stacked card. United States Championships, Tag Team Champions on the line. Man, I mean, just title matches. Then we have grudge matches. I'm forgetting. Nick Hammonds is putting his Mountain Empire title on the line.
That's right.
Tonight, I mean, plus we have grudge matches. We have a Falls Count Anywhere match between the two men in the ring here. The two men on the opposite, on one side of the ring, Gavin Daring and Toby Farley, the agency, taking on in a Falls Count Anywhere match against the Heat Seekers.
Plus Jeff Connolly against the Masked Man Wild Bill.
That's right. And, you know, let's not forget the television title match with Ali Shabazz taking on the champion, Jordan Cage. No time limit. And if Jordan gets disqualified, Ali will be the NWA Smoky Mountain Television Champion.
The big question for me tonight is, are we going to see Vince Brent do it and become a world champion tonight in Kingsport, challenging Steve Anthony for that NWA World Junior Heavyweight title? We have seen that championship change hands multiple times here in the NWA Smoky Mountain Squared Circle. Chase Owens, Jason Kincaid, Ricky Morton, they've all won the gold here in this promotion. Can Vince Brent become the latest NWA Smoky Mountain product to join that exclusive fraternity of world title holders? We'll find out tonight.
Coming off an injury, I'm not sure. You know, I mean, Vince Brent, serious illness. He had a serious illness that kept him out a Fire on the Mountain, has kept him out all month long, but he's been training for the NWA World Junior Heavyweight title match with Steve Anthony. And I don't know, we'll have to see what kind of shape he's in, and we'll have to see that maybe we may see a new world champion crowned tonight. And it would be a man from Kingsport, Tennessee. A man born and bred in Kingsport, Tennessee. Could he walk away with it? But let's not forget, many, many great matches. Let's see what we got going on here in the ring. Toby Farley, big right hand, big kick by Ali Shabazz.
His educated feet being put to good use by Shabazz.
Just teeing off on him, pushes him back to the corner, shoots him off here. Big splash. You know, a lot of guys use splash, like Wild Bill or even the Daniel Mulligan or Chris Richards or the John Aron, now known as Travis Lee, use a splash in the corner, and it's their weight that it's all weight, all impact. The impact from Ali Shabazz's splash comes from his leaping ability, comes from his literally he's got springs for legs and just
nice drop kick there.
Right there. Big drop kick by Ali Shabazz, and Nick Hammond's here following up with a wrist lock here. Full arm drag and twist. Now he's going to shoot the man off.
Nick did a good job there using his own body, shielding Farley off from his partner Gavin Darien, preventing the tag. Throwing a nice arm drag there.
Good. Nick Hammond's there working the arm. Got the arm bar cinched up. Toby Farley needs to pull him away. And look at that, right in front of the referee, rake to the eyes. Tag to Gavin Darien. Another big arm drag. I'm not sure if he got all of that eye rake. So it doesn't look like it's affecting Nick Hammond.
Going for the hair there. Boy, Toby Farley, it's been a very impressive few weeks for him. Made his debut out of nowhere 3 weeks ago on this program as the agency, you know, and the Heat Seekers parted ways. Then pushed Jason Kincaid to the limit in that NWA Southeastern title match. We'll see Kincaid defend the gold, as we mentioned, tonight against Ring of Honor star Cedric Alexander. And then tonight, the big grudge match for the agency against those Heat Seekers. Falls count anywhere. We could see it end on, you know, in the lobby, out in the fans, maybe out on Fort Henry Drive. Who knows? You'll have to be there tonight in Kingsport and find out for yourself.
It's going to be an incredible matchup. You know, we've seen Toby Farley. We've seen that he can wrestle. We know that Gavin Darien can wrestle. We know that
big
Sidney can
there.
Wrestle. We know that Elliot Russell. Now we get to see these guys fight, and they are going to have a fight all over Kingsport tonight. And imagine that, Toby Farley making his debut at the Kingsport Civic Auditorium, the mecca of wrestling in East Tennessee. He's going to make it in a big match. This guy's really sprung onto the scene.
Big kick to the back. Toby Farley, he's not come here to play around. He is here to make an impact. And as I've said in previous weeks, kind of a testament to the scouting of Dillon Wayne Sizemore. You can hate him, and a lot of people do, but he definitely has an eye for talent when it comes to what goes on in between those ropes.
Nick Hammond's fighting back now. Shoot, hitting on the rope. Could it be? Big drop kick. Great drop kick by Gavin Darien there. He hit Nick Hammond's flush. Ali Shabazz.
Shabazz in to break it up.
Ali Shabazz coming in, breaking it up. I don't think he's not helping his case by arguing with the referee.
Curious what's going to be the game plan of Nick Hammond tonight as he goes against Travis Lee 2 weeks ago on this program. Nick Hammond's blasted Travis Lee in the head twice with that steel chair. Didn't even faze the big man. So what's Nick Hammond's going to be able to do in a conventional wrestling match against the Giant?
I'm not sure. You know, I've talked to Nick, and he says he has a strategy, and we'll see if he can implement that strategy tonight. But I've seen, you know, I've heard a very famous quote, all strategies go out of the window when you get punched in the face. So we'll see what happens.
Speaking of strategy, the Illuminati kind of going back to their old tactics in recent weeks, putting those U.S. tag titles on the line against Axe and Rain, Skylar Cruz, in the announcement that we gave you earlier from R. Bruce Tharp. And, you know, the champion's definitely not happy about that situation. They don't even think they need to put the titles on the line, as the agency have kind of incited Ali Shabazz in the ring, and now some double teaming on Nick Hammond's.
And let's not forget about Cedric Alexander. I'm not sure what happened there. Nick Hammond's escaped. Tried to hit the ropes on the other side, and Gavin Darien regains control and cuts him right back off.
I think Nick Hammond might just be kind of rattled after some of the punishment he's taken. We've talked about Toby Farley's punishing strikes. He's taken several of them, plus that big drop kick by Gavin Darien. Excuse me.
And that DDT doesn't help.
No, right it does
on,
not.
Right on top of his head, you know what? That DDT, you see it used a lot. That is a finishing maneuver. You're taking a man in front face lock, and you're dropping him on his skull. And look, you see Nick Hammond's holding his head here, still holding his head. He's feeling the effects of that DDT.
Kevin Darien.
What could he go for?
He's got something in mind here.
Could be going for that frog splash. What is going on here? He's going up top.
Waited a little too long. Nick Hammond's caught him in the breadbasket. Double axe handle. Hits that clothesline.
I don't think Nick got all of that hit to the breadbasket, but he got enough to evade and then to get the big clothesline on Gavin Darien. He was able to get out of the way.
Definitely got all of that clothesline.
For sure. And look at this. Can he make the tag?
There's the tag. Ali and Toby Farley both in fresh. Ali with a big clothesline of his own. Gavin Darien gets one. Ali is cooking. Foot chop to Gavin Darien.
Big kick. Here it comes.
Spin kick.
Spin kick. Rolling. Splash.
Rolling Shabazz splash, but Gavin pulled referee Smoke Carver in the way.
Referee is down, and this is never good, especially when Dylan Sizemore's out.
Oh, my goodness. What here comes going? Chaos. What is Chaos doing out here? They're going after Nick Hammonds, I think. Travis Lee, could he leave tonight as the Mountain Empire champion? Chaos hitting the ring, the agency in the ring, and we've got a 4-on-2 beatdown right now, Tony Gibbons.
This is insanity right here.
The handshake.
I'm not sure what's going on here. Man,
handshake between Judas the Mad Hatter and
they've taken him out of the ring here. Referee, he doesn't know anything about this. Ali Shabazz is by himself against two men. I don't think Ali knows.
Well, here comes Jordan Cage.
Here comes Jordan Cage, who faces Ali Shabazz tonight.
Jordan Cage attacking the man who's going to be facing
Wild Bill with the chair.
This
is a wild situation here. It looks like this. What is going on here?
Everybody. I mean, it's all these men. You're going to see him in action tonight, Fire in the Mountain. Here comes Elliot Russell. Here comes Sigmund, the Heat Seekers. Jordan Cage in the ring trying to hit the Hangman's pile driver. Elliot Russell breaks it up. My goodness. It's like a standoff. What's going on here?
Toby Farley here. He's going to suplex Ali Shabazz into the ring here. Oh, he tripped him. Sigmund tripped him. He's tripped him.
He's got him pinned.
Ali Shabazz lands on top. Wild
the Heatseekers cost Cody Blade charging
we
in.
Have
here comes
every,
Wild Bill.
What is going on here? We got a Wild
Bill. We got a standoff. Oh,
well with
Wild
everybody.
Bill gets attacked with the cane. Things are breaking down.
Everything's going to be settled tonight. We got all kinds of matches. We got title matches. We have grudge matches. Tonight in Kingsport, it's breaking down here. It's going to continue. Tonight in Kingsport, Civic Auditorium, Battle of the Belts, 8 p.m. Do not miss it.